I have to ask, too, why I have you here. What was it like playing with Paul McCartney? Was that just a...
You know, Paul is not only the nicest person in the world, and he's not only a Beatle, but he is an incredible musician.
Oh, yeah.
And so it's, I mean, sometimes you forget that he could be the most badass bass player you've ever seen in your entire life. And he just wants to jam.
Yeah, and he can just rip.
He just wants to rip.
I'm so glad he didn't play bass when we were playing.
Really? Why?
So, yeah, because he just smokes on the bass. And I learned everything I know from him.
He oh, really? Like yeah, like you were intimidated
yeah,
by him?
Really? Good. Really? So you know, he comes in and he's playing this left-handed...
Sig fiddle.
Sig fiddle.
He played this guitar. It's like this little guitar made out of a cigar box.
Why did he choose that?
He was standing there. He walks into the studio. He's like, hello, hello. And he had his legendary Les Paul guitar, the bass that he's played on everything, and this cigar box thing. And he's like, no, I think I'll just play this.
He's like, are you sure? Like, you're Paul McCartney. He's like, I think I want to play the kazoo.
But then he tore it up. That's the thing.
I don't want you playing the kazoo. You're Paul McCartney. Yeah.
Yeah.
You want him to jam out.
He shot me a riff, and I picked it up. And I shot him a riff, and he picked it up. And Dave's jamming, and Pat's there. And then I look around, and I'm looking at Dave and Pat, and I'm like, and I forgot about Paul. I'm like, wait a minute, I haven't played with these fellows for 20 years.
Yeah.
So it's kind of bittersweet. And there's this left-handed guitar player standing there.
It was a trip.
It was a trip.
Right? A left-handed. And we
was like riding
a bike. Left-handed.
He was left-handed.
Curtin, I think I said, I read somewhere that you go to pawn shops now, and then you look at
I did that
cheap
for years.
Left-handed guitars for $100 or less, and you think about Kurt and buying one for him because he would just smash his guitar.
Yeah, we would do that and buy a left-handed guitar or a right-handed guitar that we could flip over easily.
Oh yeah, I can't smash guitar. I tried to do it once. Of course, I'm a comedian first.
They're hard to break.
They're really hard to break, and I just kept smashing it and hitting it, and everyone's like laughing at me, and nothing was happening. The guitar was perfectly fine, and I was like, I was grunting louder than I was like, I was trying to smash, and everyone's like. You were so not a rock star, dude. Stop doing this. I was like, whatever. I just unplugged it.
Pete Townsend walks out.
Like, Pete Townsend, yeah, he's like, sure, just shaking his head, like, I'm leaving. But you just smash everything. You just love to do it. It was fun.
Well, it would make our sets like sensational, and then we'd play for 45 minutes, maybe 50 minutes, because Kurt was so intense, you know, and he'd be out there intense and. 45, 50 minutes, and we can get off if we smashed everything. But then we played live shows.
That's true. You can't do an encore if everything's broken.
Right.
Genius!
Genius.
Genius
kind of
idea.
It was kind of a shtick. But then we played live shows for like 2 hours.
There's this one, we were on tour in Chicago, and Kurt had been chopping at my drums all tour, and like my drums had holes in them. Like there were, and they sounded like crap because there were holes in them. They didn't sound good. And I kept asking our tour manager, could I please get a new drum set? And this is before we were playing big places, we were in clubs. He's like, let's wait another week. And I said, and he chopped more holes and wait another week. And so finally I said to Kurt, it's at the Metro in Chicago. I said, hey man, at the end of the gig, we have to smash my drum set to splinters. Because I need a new
record industry guy was there. The record label guy was there, so he could buy. He had the credit card.
But the guitars, man, we spent half an hour breaking those drums. And we told the audience, we said, you can go home. It's all good.
And we're just going to break all this.
Yeah.
The concert's over, so give
and
us
And then
a
the next day, the drum place was closed. And I was just like,
oh, my God. You're sitting there, yeah, playing the kazoo. Nirvana. I can't be more happy for you guys. I know all the fans are proud of you guys and happy. We wish Kurt was here, but you guys are the greatest. Thank you for coming on the show. Congratulations. Dave Grohl, Chris Novoselic.